When you're getting started with while loops, it's important to note the main difference between for loops and while loops. So basically the idea are for loops is whenever you know ahead of time how many times you want to do something. I can't spell. And then while loops, except I can't spell that either, is when you're not sure. Okay, so whenever you're not sure how many times you want to do something, but you know you want to do it multiple times, then you're going to use a while loop. If you know precisely how many times you want to do something, then you're going to do a for loop. So for example, I'm going to say x equals 1, and I'm going to say while x is equal to 1, so I'm going to set x equal to 1, and while x equals 1, I'm going to do an input statement where x is equal to input, is this annoying yet? And there's going to be an answer is yes or no. Okay, so do. And I'm not going to suppress anything just so you can kind of see what's going on. So now I want you to run this code. So you go, seriously? Oh, not input. Sorry, menu. Menu. There we go. All right, is this annoying yet? Yes. Is this annoying yet? Yes. And it just keeps asking you, right? Because you're like, this is stupid. When will this go away? I already told you that it was annoying, but it keeps asking me if it's annoying. Okay, so why does it keep coming up? And the answer is, well, every time I click yes, x returns as a 1. And as long as x is equal to 1, it's going to keep asking. So the only way to get out of this is to get a return that's not equal to 1. And I can do that by either hitting the x, which will return a 0, or I can do it by hitting no, which will return a 2. So as long as I keep saying that it's annoying, it's going to keep asking me. It's kind of like a little sister or something like that. Is this annoying yet? I'm not hitting you. No, I'm not touching you. Okay, so anyway, so that's a while loop. It's basically when you want to do something over and over and over again until a certain condition is met. Now I could always say while x is equal to 1, I could say while x is not equal to 2. So then it would be, if I ran this, it would be like, is this annoying yet? And if it says a 1, then it's not equal to 2. A 1 is not equal to 2. A 1 is not equal to 2. A 1 is not equal to 2. A 0 is not equal to 2. So even though I'm xing out of it, it's still asking me. And the only way to break out of it is to make x actually equal to 2 is by saying no. Kind of makes sense? So while loops are pretty good for getting data or input or processing input from a user. So the only thing is you always have to remember to initialize your value. So like up here, I specifically had to say x equals 1. If I took that out like that and I try to run it, nothing would happen. So if I hit this, it says the x is undefined, so it actually can't decide whether or not it's going to run the while loop. Now, if I, for some reason, had initialized it where x was equal to 2, then it's still not going to run it. It's not going to do anything. It's just going to say x equals 2. It's never going to ask the question because it's like, well, I only run this when x is not equal to 2, but it is equal to 2, so I guess you don't want me to run it. So you really want to be careful. That's one of the first things people do wrong whenever they're doing while loops, just like when you're doing for loops, is not initializing values properly and in advance. No, it's not an open thing. Okay. So, but like I was saying, you can use this a lot with user input. So say you want to know, I don't know, say you're going to ask them, what is x, what is 3 plus 2? All right, so if I want to ask what is 3 plus 2, I could say, well, if x is not equal to 5, then I want to ask again, okay? And this is not a good way to do this. And then I could say, well, if it's still not equal to 5, I want to ask again. If it's still not equal to 5, I want to ask again. If it's still not equal to 5, I want to ask again. If it's still not equal to 5, I want to ask again. So basically what I've done is I've put in, six questions. Okay, so I'm going to ask, what is 3 plus 2? And I'm going to say, I'm going to miss it once, and then I miss it twice, and I miss it 3 times, and I miss it 4 times, 5 times, and 6 times, and it just finally stops asking me. So the nice part about a while loop is it's going to keep asking over and 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 over. So what I could do is instead of saying if x is not equal to 5, what is it? I could say while x is not equal to 5, what is it? Okay, does that kind of make sense? So then what this is going to do What is this? It's zero. No, what is it? What is it? What is it? What is it? And it's just going to keep asking. As long as I get it wrong, it's going to keep asking me for the answer. And when I finally get it right, it'll say, yay, thanks. Now, this is a little silly because I'm actually having to ask this question twice. So what if I decide, oh, I really wish it had a little space here. So I fix that, but then I forget to fix it in the other spot. So it's fixed once, but not all the time. So generally, rather than doing something like this, what I would do is I'd set x equal to something that I know is not going to be 5. So I set it equal to, you know, that or something like that. So I know that that's not going to be the right answer, so that it'll automatically go into the while loop. And so now it's really only asking it. It's really only asking it that first time. I like to get the right answer. Okay, so that kind of make sense. That's kind of one of the ways that you'd like to do a while loop. Another thing that you can do with a while loop is you can make what we call infinite while loops. So let's say that I set x was equal to, so this is a very common mistake. So what if I had this, I'm gonna use this exact same code, but I'm gonna, for some reason, I'm gonna say y. And I'm gonna run this, and oops, sorry. I'm gonna go CLC clear, and I'm gonna run this, and I'm gonna say, what is 3 plus 2? And I'm like, 5. It's like, no, what is 3 plus 2? And I'm like, 5. It's like, no, what is 3 plus 2? And it's doing this forever and ever and ever. You're like, this makes no sense because I keep getting it right. And I'm going to put in, you know, burger. Burger. Oh, no, still. Very stupid because, you know, this code doesn't work. And you're like, it's 5. Ah. So what's wrong with my code? So basically what's going on, and I'm going to, so what you need to do to get out of this is you need to hit Control C. So Control C. But not type it, just typing it so you can see what I was saying. But you're going to hit the Control button and the C button, and then it gets out of it. But this is an infinite while loop because I screwed it up. I messed up big time. Because what I'm not doing is I'm not changing the value that I'm checking on. So this is also something you want to look at when you're doing a for loop, is are you actually changing the value that you're doing the check on? Is it ever possible to get out of the loop? So obviously this is a bad thing to do that. Like that, so I'd have to fix it. Another thing you could do with an infinite while loop, so I could say, for infinite while loops, I could say, well, x is equal to 5. And I'm gonna say, while x is greater than 3, I wanna say x is equal to x plus 1. So basically the idea is I want to set x is equal to 5, and every time I go through the loop, I want to add 1 to x until x is greater than 3. Or until, while x is greater than 3, not until x is greater than 3, but while x is greater than 3, I want to keep adding 1. And obviously the problem with this is that x is always going to be greater than 3 because it started out as 1 and I keep adding to it. So this is definitely not something that we like. So I want to go ahead and I want to hit Control C to get out of this. So I click down in the trial, or not in the trial, I click down in the command window section and I hit Control C, and that will get me out of that while loop. Now what we just had here is a pretty interesting little while loop thingy. Really understanding, limits or endpoints on while loops. So if I have something like this, and I'm gonna change it a little bit. So I'm gonna say while, so let's start out with, I'll leave it this way, but instead of adding 1, I'm going to subtract 1. So I'm going to start off with x is equal to 5. So let's think ahead about what this could possibly look like. Okay, so it's going to be, x is going to be equal to 5. And then while x is greater than 3, I want to subtract 1. So I'll say x greater than 3, yes. So x is equal to x minus 1, which is 4. Is x greater than 3? Well, 4 is greater than 3, yes. So x is now equal to 4 minus 1, which is 3. All right, is x greater than 3? No, because 3 isn't greater than 3, so we're done. X is still 3. Okay, so whenever I run this, what I expect to see is that it's going to come back with x is equal to 3. And that's exactly what happens. So then you think, okay, well, I'm going to take the same code, and I'm going to say, well, what happens if x is, if I change it to while x is greater than or equal to 3? Okay, so this is important. While x is greater than or equal to 3, I want to use to subtract 1 off of it. So now I say, well, is x greater than or equal to 3? Yes, that stays the same. Yes, that stays the same. But whenever I get here, I say, well, is 3 greater than or equal to 3? Well, yeah, it is. Yeah, so now x is going to equal 3 minus 1, which is 2. And so then I say, well, is x greater than or equal to 3? No, because it's 2. No, because it's not. No, because it's 2. And so since it's 2, it's no longer greater than or equal to 3, so I quit. So x is still 2. So x, the value of x doesn't change, it's now going to be 2. So here, x finishes out to be 2, whereas in this example, x finished out to be 3. And that's the difference between having the greater than or equal to versus the greater than, the strictly greater than on the while loop. There's all kinds of stuff that you can do with these, and understanding kind of how these work is one of those things that you, I think, if it's not something that you get right away, it's just one of those things you got to play with it in order to get it to stick. So for example, we could come in here and I could say, what's really good practice, I guess, is what I'm saying, is to come in here and practice and think about if you can anticipate what the output of the code is going to be. So I have to say x is equal to 7. And I'll say, well, while x is less than 20, I want x to increase by 3. Okay, so take a minute, see if you can figure out what the output of that code would be. So while x is less than 20, x is going to be equal to x plus 3. So if you write out all the steps, do like we did before, where you say, you know, is x less than 20. So in this case, x is 7. So is 7 less than 20? Yes. So x is now going to be equal to 7 plus 3, which is 10. Okay. So kind of walk through that process. Pause the video. See if you can get it to make sense before you run it and see if you can get the right answer. Okay. So we'll pretend that happened and we'll say, so is 10 less than 20? Yes. So now x equals 10 plus 3 is 13. And I keep going. Is 13 less than 20? So x is going to equal 13 plus 3, so it's 16. Is 16 less than 20? Yes, see, so x is equal to 16 plus 3 is 19. Is 19 less than 20? Yes, so x is equal to 19 plus 3 is 22. Is 22 less than 20? No, so we're good. Okay, so that's kind of what I'm talking about. So the final value of this should be, so x is still 22. So the value of x is still 22. So this is really all it's doing is it's not running. Come on. Oh, it's because I suppressed everything. It's like x is 22 here. You can't see it. There we go. So x is 22. So what you really want to be able to do is to kind of look at while loops and be able to kind of tell, well, what is this going to do? And really, it's really hard a lot of times just to look at it and get it. Sometimes it helps to just kind of go through a step like this and go through a process like this so you can really get used to the idea of what this for loop is actually doing.